This video is intended to help you visualize the front, top, and right side view of the objects in exercise 2.2. So this is the first object. There is the front view. Here's the top view. Back to the front view. And here's the right side view. Back to the front view. Back to the isometric view. This is the second object in exercise 2.2. Front view, top view, back to the front view, right side view, back to the front view, back to the top view, back to the front view, right side view, back to front, back to the isometric view. This is the third object in exercise 2.2. Front view, top view. You'll notice there are a lot of hidden lines created in this one, so I'm going to go back to the front view. So some of those hidden lines come from where these planes break here on these edges, and some are the outside edges of that hole. So back to the top view, back to the front view, then to the right side view, back to the front view, and you'll see there's a hidden line coming across here. If we go to the right side view, you can see it's this plane that goes behind right there. Back to the front view, back to the isometric view. So here is the fourth object, isometric view. Front view, top. So we can see the incline planes, these four incline planes, and then this is a normal plane here. Back to the front, then to the right, incline plane right here. Back to the front, back to the top, back to the front, to the right. And I think what's helpful on this one is to see the bottom of it. That may help you figure out what some of these planes look like that you're seeing here. Kind of get an idea for that right here. So back to the isometric. And that's it. Here is the fifth object. Front view, and you can see we have an arc shape in here. Let's go to the top view, and you can see this arc and this arc. So the center for that arc lies somewhere in this area in here. And so you have to think about, well, should there be a center mark for the center of this arc? So let's go back to front, back to top, back to front, and then to the right side, back to the front view, back to the right, back to front, and then back to the isometric view. This is the sixth object, front view, top view, front view, right side view. Let's go back to the front view. Now I want you to think about this plane right here and where this arc comes across, and then we have a flat plane for just a short distance, and then we go into another arc. Think about this entire thing, and then let's go look at that in the top view. So we're going to see the edge of that plane up here. This is going to be a visible line, and then this curve runs out and blends into this plane here, and you actually will not see a line across right here, because once that blends in, it's going to go away. So if I turned off the visibility of that line right there, it would be more accurate. But this 3D modeler I'm using shows those tangent edges where things come together, but that's just going to blend out and there would not be lines across here and here. All of this would be one smooth blend. All right, so let's go to Object 7, Front View. Look at the hidden lines. Let's relate those. Top View, a lot of hidden lines in the top view. Let's go back to the front view, and let's go to the ISO again so we can kind of see where all these hidden lines are coming from. So we have hidden lines for the outside edges of this hole. This hole, we have a hidden line for this corner coming across. We've got a hidden line running right down through the center right here. So let's go back to front. Let's go to top. Back to the front. So you can see we're going to have a visible line where these two corners come together in that half round shape that we have right there. So back to the front and then to the right. All right, so what we see is a hidden line coming across here and going up, and that represents that half round that's cut out. So here's this is the right side view. Let's go back to the front. So you can see that half round. The half round ends when it gets to this plane here. And so that's why we will have a hidden line coming straight down right in here. Back to the ISO view. Here's the eighth object. Front view. Top view. Back to the front view. Right side view. Back to front. Go to the top, back to the front, back to the right, back to the front, and then to the ISO view. And this is the ninth object, front view. So let's go back to the ISO and look at where those hidden lines are coming from. The edges of holes, these two holes, this line that comes across that runs behind here. So let's go to the front view. Let's go to the top. The three hidden lines we're getting here, if we go back to front view, are from this edge, and this edge over here. So let's go to the right side. Let's go back to the front. Let's go back to the right. Looks like for some reason this is showing up as a visible or a dark line, but actually that's a hidden line for the side of the hole. So let's go back. So you can see we have the edges of these two holes. And so let's go to the front view again and then over to the right, back to the front, and then back to the ISO view.